404 errors happen when someone requests a page or file that the web server can't find. I'm Kate, and I'm going to show you how to identify and fix these errors with RankMath's 404 monitor. If you can't see this feature in the left sidebar of your admin panel, open RankMath's dashboard to enter the plugin's advanced mode. There, you need to activate the 404 monitor module. It will start registering 404 errors once you activate it, so when you open it for the first time, you'll probably see an empty log. You will notice there are three fields in the 404 monitor. URI, which means Uniform Resource Identifier, and represents the URL that the user tried to access. Hits, the number of times the error-causing URI was accessed, and access time, that captures the time of the last hit on the URI. But there's an important limitation to this data, since it does not tell you if the error was caused internally or from an external website. To find the source of the problem, click on Settings to switch to 404 Monitor's Advanced Mode. The 404 Monitor tab of RankMath's General Settings will open. We recommend that you only use the Advanced 404 Monitor if you need additional information about where the 404s might be coming from. That's because instead of grouping errors by their URI, the Advanced Monitor will show them individually, which might increase your error log significantly. After you click on Advanced, remember to save the changes. Since each error only has one hit, this column will be replaced by two others, Referrer and User Agents. Their data will only be available for the errors that happen after you've switched to Advanced. Referrer shows the URL for the page that contains the wrong link, even when that page belongs to another website. If it's empty, the error was due to a typo or another mistake in the address. User Agent shows the browser where the error happened. This is important because it might be happening in a browser different from the one you're using, so you wouldn't be able to reproduce the error and understand how to fix it. The list may seem overwhelming, but there are tools to help you browse through it. You can increase or decrease the number of visible errors in a page by clicking on Screen Options button on the top. Keep in mind that items per page is the number of 404s you can see on one page before having to use the pagination to move to the next one. If you wish to change the total number of errors recorded, you need to click on Settings at the top of the page. The 404 Monitor tab of RankMath's General Settings will open with the Log Limit option. Enter your preferred number there and save the changes. To find specific errors, you can open your browser search functionality with the keyboard shortcut Ctrl plus F on Windows and Command plus F on a Mac. RankMath also has a search option, but it only works with exact matches, so you need to enter that part of the URL exactly as it appears in the URI field. You can also order the URIs alphabetically or by the number of hits and access time. The last two columns should be taken into account when you decide which errors to start with. For instance, looking for the errors with the higher hits and most recent last access. Before we start fixing the 404s, let's take a quick look at the options in the 404 Monitor tab of RankMath's General Settings. We've already covered the mode and log limit. The third, exclude paths, can be quite useful when you're making some changes to your website. It stops unimportant URLs from filling up the log and hiding real errors. You can set exclusions where the 404 monitors will not check for errors, using exact URLs, categories, keywords, or even regular expressions, also known as regex. It's possible to create more exclusion rules and have multiple exceptions. The last setting, ignore query parameters, tells the monitor to ignore the part of the URL that comes after a question mark. If you see a lot of errors in the log file that have the same URL but different query parameters, you can enable this to have a cleaner log. Now that you know how to analyze the errors, it's time to decide what to do with them. For that, you need to think about how visitors are finding that page. They can be classified in two categories. First are direct visitors, which access your website directly through typing or pasting the URL. Sometimes they type the wrong URL in their browsers and there is nothing you can do. Other times, the URI shows a correct spelling and the original URL was the one with a typo. This is the easiest type of 404 because you can fix it from the page editor. Click on the card to know how. Then there are referral visitors that can come from other websites, social networks, or even search engines. To see those referrals, you'll need to switch to the advanced monitor. If the referral error is internal, you can fix the broken source link in your content. However, when the referral is external, you'll need to contact the website's owners and ask them to link to the correct URL, instead of the one that is causing a 404. When you can't fix a problematic URL, for instance, if those website owners didn't respond to your request, it's time to redirect visitors to another destination using RankMath's redirection tool. To do that, you can click on Redirect right below the URI and make a simple redirection. If you don't know how to use this tool, click on the card to watch our tutorial. On the other hand, when several different URIs are related to the same page, you can select them in the checkbox to the left and use the Bulk Actions drop-down menu to redirect them all at once. They will appear as source URIs in the redirection for the same destination URL. If you're not sure about which page or post a URI should redirect to, you can investigate by picking keywords and searching them in your posts. Once the error URL is redirected, the number of hits will be in the redirections page instead of the 404 monitor. So you should remove that 404 error from the list. Just hover over the error and click on the delete option. The last option when handling 404 errors is ignoring them. This applies to URIs that have nothing to do with your site, especially related to sales or giveaways. They are caused by malicious users, spammers, and bad bots. You can delete them from your 404 logs individually or with the help of bulk actions. If you've handled all the genuine errors and are left with a big list of spam 404s to delete, you can just click on the Clear Log button to the right. But be careful. Clearing the log might be useful for testing purposes, but it's unlikely that you would use it during the normal course of management for your website. Only use it if you know what you're doing. Once the log is cleared, there is no way to get the lost data back. Only the errors that are recorded after clearing will be displayed. If this tutorial helped you, give it a like. If you have any questions, click on the link in the description to open a free support ticket. You can find other tutorials and videos in our knowledge base at rankmath.com/kb.